Welcome back to Let's Play Cyberpunk 2077 Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, heading for our second to last Cyber Psycho mission. Not everyone's made for Maelstrom. Some, surprise, surprise, don't take well to having half their face chopped off. They start hearing voices, seeing and imagining things. Then it's enough to get their hands on a gun, and that recipe for disaster is ready to serve. Yeah, I don't know who the hell would ever do anything like that. Both me and him peeled out at the same time. Ready for the next one. So we're kind of getting near the end of this. We're wrapping up various things. Cutting through here. Who wants to fight me back there? I mean, I'll oblige you.
This is the fucking end.
It's a thug for the scavengers. I don't know why he wanted to fight me. That's Dominic. Dominic's alright.
Yep. Look, it's just like you're telling. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Then where? I know where it is.
A maniac.
It's just a matter of time, motherfucker!
Yeah, I've heard that one before. Oh, I leveled up. Oh! I got knocked on my ass. I'm jumping though. I fell on nothing. There we go. Ugh. Shut up. Thank you. Seiko's Darknet tactical balaclava with nanotubing. Spooky noise. I know I killed everyone already. Oh, nothing here. Guess I'll take their car. Not this song again. Oh, hey. Head back this way.
Stand here. The sun is down, but I hope you're still up.
I am.
Several independent studies have concluded that half of all manual laborers in Night City are expected to die before the age of 70.
Really?
If you have the strength, go to work. If you don't, you go anyway. Either die of the job or die of hunger. Choice is yours. First world problems.
Wonderful.
Am I right?
Can I just run over there? I'll go the way they say, just in case it's another level or something. Never heard this song before. Supposed to disappear. There you go.
What in the fuck?
Search the area for survivors.
You okay?
This guy?
Lilith has concealed the 10th circle from the ancestors' eyes.
What?
The hell is this?
Got a bad feeling, V.
That thing just dropped.
Better look around.
I'm getting spooked now. Maelstrom cultist. Mortally wounded. Severe blood loss from multiple shallow lacerations. Critical condition. Cyberware. Characteristic of Maelstrom, if not for the atypical color. Bleeding from the eyes and numerous stab wounds. No indications of resistance. Same one there. Same there. And same there.
Hmm.
A lamp. Industrial fluorescent lighting with manually altered color and intensity, positioned along the perimeter of a circle on the ground. Wait, what was, there's someone over there. Wait. I don't like this. Well, I saw that. I don't like this. One bit. Get spooked. Majorly spooked. What's that? A car. I really just want to leave. That's you?
V, we got company.
Oh! Ew. Zaria Hughes? Maelstrom. Break hold, send a vista, charge jump. Neutralize the threat. Whoa.
Killer!
Wait, I had it. I don't know where she is, I don't like it. Whoa! Whoa. Malfunction! Fire or something, or she set me on fire. I'm about to die. Yeah, I still have one hit point. I don't like that disappearing act she pulls off. Not a fan. Boy, I couldn't move for a second. About to tell me we're not alone?
V, we got company.
Yeah, I know. I can't target her now.
Blasphemer!
I are not the blasphemer. Where is she? Whoa, 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 whoa. Cyberwell malfunction. Stop. Reloading. Whoa. This is faster, right? Whoa. I'm stuck. Where is she now? Oh. She's like, it's like she's summoning herself. Oh my god! Alright. We're trying a different tack now. Wow. My different tack didn't work. I got her down less than half, though. What, is this the toughest one? Hold up. So what if I can get some elevation here? Don't kill her. Oh, she sounded nasty there. Wow. Now, I'd hit her with the Cyberwell malfunction, but it takes too long. Can I jump up anywhere? go again. Kill her, yeah. Distance. I got her. Don't die. Don't die. Oh my God, that was hard. Hell yeah, I saved the game. Maelstrom's Cultist Shard. Encrypted Shard. Oh. The hard reset approaches. The boys have prepared everything and found me a lamb. Blood will course through the fiber optics, swirling and blending with the digital, opening the gates of the abyss. Death within arm's reach, the metallic taste of his scythe on my tongue. I will tug at the tangled cables of fate. A hard reset, a blue screen, a brain reformatted. I'm ready. Luck be with me. Wow. That was the worst one. That was the worst cyber psycho out of any of them. And she came out of... She was in here. Freezer. An old freezer. Contents. Ice. Not only ice. Possibly related to net running operations. And there's like organs or something in there. There's like a hand sticking out. Crazy. Anything else around here? A generator thing over there. I'm assuming. Set up for her. I want to crack the shard. Oh, I can level up. Wait a second. Let's do that first. I'm gonna put in body again. And then... Not sure if I want any of these things. These all have to do with knives. Poison. Quick melee attacks with ranged weapons. I never do that. Oops. Ice pick demon. Hmm. Now let's see what we have. Shards, but... Is it gonna show up in here? I have a feeling not, because it's a special one, right? These are all the archive conversations and stuff. Other. It's time. Oh, that's it. Okay. Crack security. All right. I can't. It's all 1C, 1C. How can I do that? Wait. 1C. 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 C. Oh, and then BD? Failed. Okay. BD. Oh, the first one to blink, I think, so that's why. E9. 1C. 1C. Done. That didn't work. It seemed like it worked. Cyber Psycho. Oh, here. It's time. Oh, I decided to actually read it. Everything's ready. The circle is drawn. The lamb awaits the slaughter. Come as soon as you can. We can't wait anymore. My silicon craves blood. Cables are crackling. Links are sparking. Modems are groaning so loud I can't think. The Abyss is impatient. The Abyss is hungry. Well. Why does it say we still have to crack the shard? I don't know. I'm gonna message her though. Figured that would, you know, be done. Complete. So it shows red like it's not done. Police drone just spotted some weird symbols on the ground, surrounded by tons of blood. Wild guess, it's one of Maelstrom's sick-ass rituals. So I say, something about this ritual went wrong. Seriously wrong. Place is covered in guts and blood. Must have had something to do with uploading the brain into the net and straddling the border between life and death. Only the girl who jacked in couldn't handle it. She went psycho and started tearing into her chooms. I thought women were more resistant to cyberpsychosis. Anyway, at least we have her alive. Well, that could be on average. You never know. Could be an individualistic thing. Maybe most women are more resistant. Just, she's not one of most women. It's true, women are less likely to get cyberpsychosis. All the better we have her alive for more research. I thought nothing could surprise me anymore. Boy, was I wrong. Wonder what she heard through those cables. What caused her to crack. I'll keep looking into it. In the meantime, I'm sending you your cut. Bonus included. Property developer tossed in token of their gratitude for freeing up the building that Maelstrom was squatting in. Not bad, huh? Okay. Looks like this was supposed to be some trip to the other side. In a tub filled with ice and the blood of innocents, Maelstrom never ceases to amaze and disgust. Techno necromancers, without a doubt. I guess this conversation's over. Okay. So this is the last one here, 6 feet under. Job complete. What's going on over here? I was about to partake in some reading. That's a Maelstrom fanatic.
You done shit in your pants yet?
No, no, please, no.
We got a situation!
Yeah, situation of you dying. That's funny, because I don't have any. That's Ramon Menezes. Well, I get to loot the police officers and the Maelstrom goons. Dynamite? Thank you very much. Keep on moving. I said keep on moving. He's like, dead bodies, I'm going back the way I came. Under this light here, we'll do a little bit of reading, not too much. Oops. Oh, not shards. Database. So the only things we had left to read was all these vehicles. And I tend to think I didn't read this one, but I'll read it now. So it's a Quadra Turbo R VTEC. What's the difference between the VTEC and the classic Turbo R? By the way, this is going to be the rest of the episodes. If you guys want to tune out now, feel free. Well, what's the difference between a diamond and a chunk of coal? The building blocks are the same, but end results couldn't be more different. Quadra's Turbo R VTEC is the queen of the road, a car that turns heads even when you're not burning rubber. Quadra Type 66640TS. Faster than a bat out of hell. Breaking news? Hardly. Originally released in 2055, the Quadra was quickly adopted by edge runners and illegal street racers. For the NCPD, a Quadra tearing up the streets means a long list of traffic violations, but rarely has a patrol car ever managed, or even tried, to pull one over. Even try to pull one over. Thornton Colby C240T. The perfect example of a typical middle-of-the-road car. Its reliable performance on both city streets and interstate highways is the reason the Colby has become a favorite of nomads and urban courier services alike. The first model rolled off the assembly line in Chicago in 2045, with its reliability and simple construction paving the way to immediate and immense commercial success. By 2060, over 5 million units had been manufactured. Somehow, there are even more being used on the road today. Someone else manufacturing them? Thornton Colby's CX410 Butte? How does the Butte differ from the base Colby? The most important difference, the standard trunk has been replaced with a pickup truck bed. It's found popularity among small business owners who use it to transport stock, and among street thugs who find using a truck bed and tarp is more convenient than a car trunk for moving bodies. Wonderful. Thornton Colby Little Mule. Nomads, as the name suggests, don't linger too long in any one place. They're constantly on the move, and that means bringing their belongings with them. It comes as no wonder the truck bed variant of the Colby has become so popular with them. Little Mule, and that's what they call this Thornton Colby model. But beyond the name, they also swap out the standard engines for stronger ones, add light armor to the body, and install an environment projection system based on crystal dome tech in the cabin. Okay. Thornton Galena G40, 2031. Was that the year it came out? It used to be people only desired bread and circuses. Really? By the 21st century, however, automobiles were added to the list. I mean, maybe bikes before that? Without a car, you can't get to work, drop the kids off at kindergarten, or escape spontaneous turf wars. The Thornton Galena first hit roads in 2031, following a government stimulus to pump out affordable cars and give Americans a boost following the recession. As Thornton didn't have much experience producing small cars at the time, the company bought engines for the Galena from India's Mahir Motors. Unfortunately, the collaboration was not considered a success, with the Galena yielding unremarkable performance and even less remarkable sales. Still, it drives, and that's the most important thing. Thornton Galena Gecko. The Galena standard model wouldn't survive a day in the desert, but with the proper aftermarket modifications installed, it looks right at home. The Nomad Altered Galena, affectionately referred to as the Gecko, comes equipped with crystal dome technology, various Militech combat accessories, and a cleverly tuned engine. Folks in the wasteland used to laugh at the sight of a Galena, but no one's laughing now. So I'm curious here. What we got? A lot. Alright, gonna read some more. Thornton Galena GA40XT Rattler. The fact this car still drives is a miracle. After years of off-roading it in the desert, just about everything on this rig either creaks or grinds. The parts this car rolled off the assembly line with have been replaced by scrap metal and worn rubber. The engine's constant wheezing has you convinced the car contracted terminal tuberculosis. If this scrap heap on wheels rolled into any city shop, the mechanic would probably vomit and faint. In short, only someone truly desperate would ever catch themselves sitting behind the wheel of this mobile tetanus trap. That's funny. Thornton Mackinac Larimore. Whatever the good Lord cannot reach, he sends the Thornton Mackinac Larimore, a truck that will withstand anything, sandstorms, hailstorms, acid rain, you name it. Its resilience makes it the perfect long-distance transport vehicle. Of course, to make it on the journey, you'll have to stock up on supplies. Thankfully, the Mackinac has storage space for at least a few dozen gallons of water. Okay. Thornton Mackinac MTL-1. A staple all-purpose vehicle. Solid but not clunky, cheap but not crappy. It's perfectly suited to city roads where it's used by small and large traders alike, as well as on the desert terrain surrounding the city. Its modest engine won't propel you to any crazy speeds, but let's be real, you don't buy a pickup for racing. Thornton Mackinac Warhorse. It's no easy task surviving in the Badlands, not unless you're sitting behind the wheel of a rig like the Warhorse. Who'd believe this automotive marvel was built on the frame of the simple Thornton Mackinac? Standard body panels replaced with thick armor plates, the base engine swapped for a fire-breathing monster, and a cannon bolted to the top that even a tank pilot would be proud of. The roar of this beast carries far, causing a cold sweat to run down the back of any wraith who hears it. Mizutani Shion MZ2, 2016. The Mizutani Shion is a sports coupe par excellence, a fact most recognized from even a quick glance at its streamlined yet aggressive contours. Its five-cylinder engine offers impressive speed and quick off-the-line acceleration, all for a reasonable price. When you combine style, speed, and accessibility into one sleek package, it's no wonder the Shion is a common sight on the NC landscape, especially after hours under the lights when illegal street races tear through the city. Mizutani Shion Coyote. By looking at it, you'd think the Mizutani Shion was a city car, built for thin crust roads and unsuited for the desert wasteland, and you'd be right. The standard edition would grind to a dead halt at the first rocky knoll, but with upgrades, reinforcement, and improved suspension, the Shion cuts through harsh terrain like a laser knife through butter. And add razor knife to it. Two more. Villefort Cortez V5000 Valor 2040. Probably the most valued of all vehicles to roll out of Villefort factories, the Cortez sports a simple yet elegant design which has attracted corpos, politicians, and criminals alike. It is built on the same frame as the Alvarado, but operates on only two axles, making it more prone to breakdowns. Its impressive engine gives the Cortez a quick push off the line, and its reinforced body, created in collaboration with Militech, provides additional protection on Night City's unpredictable and dangerous streets. And finally, the Villefort Cortez V6000 NCBD Overlord. Villefort guarantees the Overlord can provide complete security in even the most extreme conditions. The heavily armored body is built to withstand continuous gunfire, and its massive engine allows for clearing obstacles such as makeshift road barricades. In an emergency, the operating officer can direct her focus on the firefight, leaving the car's central computer to take control of movement. Additionally, certain classified factory-issue components have been replaced with those often used in both Militech and Arasaka armored vehicles. In other words, the Overlord is uniquely designed to excel on the urban battlefield. Alright, so I've read that much, and I still have that much. So, maybe we're a fourth of the way through? Something like that. But next episode, we'll be going after that last Cyber Psycho. Last one, guys. Anyway, thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.